What's up, guys? XBKX Madness here. And if you guys didn't really catch that, I changed my gamer tag, I guess you could say, but a little while back my account got hacked and they changed the gamer tag, and that's what they changed it to. But I'm looking to change it again, so I'd like to start off the video by asking you guys if you guys have any suggestions as my gamer tag should be changed to again. Just leave me a comment. And right here, I cut out the first couple minutes of the video. That way, just be short enough to fit on YouTube, because I think they only allow like 10-minute videos. So yeah, I just have to cut out the first like 2 minutes. But I didn't really miss much. I died twice, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So right now, I am playing the Elite Team Slayer, and pretty much what it is it's regular Team Slayer, except you're an elite. And in Halo Reach, you have custom-made classes, you could say. So you pretty much have the same weapon loadout for each class, but what you have is a different perk. And if you look in the bottom left-hand corner, right above my little UAV, HUD thing, motion sensor, whatever you want to call it, there's this picture of the elite jumping to the side with the arrows. Now, what that is pretty much the elite's perk on both of its classes, which is different to the humans, whereas they have the same weapons, different perks. The elites have the same perks but different weapons. And I chose a class that started off with the needle rifle. And pretty much what that is if you guys have seen Milk and Cookies' video, you notice that it is the equivalent of the human DMR, which stands for Designated Marksman Rifle. And I just have to say, I love that gun. It's really good. I haven't really been able to use the DMR, but if it's anything like the needle rifle, I'm sure it'll be good. But you see me pick up the sword right here. And what I found after a couple kills is that there's a really good tactic. Now, if you combine the elite lunge with the sword lunge, as you just see me do here, the lunging distance, you could say, with the sword is increased even greater than the original one, whereas if the crosshairs just turned red. But it's just an amazing combination if you have the two. Now, a little bit more about the map's sword base. I personally don't feel like it's a good map for the Elite Team Slayer, primarily because you don't really, it's a big map and you don't really have a way to get around it faster. And pretty much what I'm trying to say is the Spartans pretty much have the jetpack and the sprint option perk. And the Elites really only have the dodger lunge, which is pretty much just an evasive maneuver if you're being shot at, and it's not really a good way to move around the map. And if I could change one thing about the beta, that would probably be it, which is just more perks for the elites and better classes. And not just for the elites for that one, but for the Spartans as well, because I personally feel like I don't use the assault rifle that much, and like, I just don't think it's a good gun. Like, it's not just Halo Reach, but also in Halo 3, I find myself picking up a BR anytime I can find one. And that's what I would really like to see here. Not just the same classes, but different, like, guns and perks and stuff. But other than that, I think that this beta is great, and you should definitely go pick it up if you have the chance. So if you have like money, you can go buy ODST and get the beta that way. I'd say go for it. But yeah. And so back to saying what I back to talking about the map sword base. It's just a big map, and it's good for like flanking people, because there are various levels and
5 minutes
various like
remaining.
bridges to get across to get behind them and pretty much have the surprise attack ready. And that's one of the things I like about this game, is that the maps are just amazing. And I just think that every single one is really good. My favorite out of all of them is definitely Powerhouse, because the map is just good. It feels right for every single game type, whether it's Capture the Flag, Team Slayer, anything. It just feels good. It feels like the map is like, I feel like I learned the map well, and then it's easy to like find where you are, and it's like, it's just a good map for everything. And these are the only two maps that I've played actually so far, but I'm looking forward to the servers being fixed, hopefully, because I know that I know when I first got on, I was having trouble finding a game and pretty much just logging in. So that was my only like complaint, I guess, is that the servers weren't doing what they were supposed to. But yeah, that's pretty much it. But I really like the two maps, Sword Base and Powerhouse, and if Halo Reach is anything like any of these other maps, I think that it's gonna do really well in a gaming market. And I think everything is pretty balanced. There's nothing that really is overpowered. But I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. If you guys like think anything's, if you've played the beta already, and you guys think there's anything overpowered or underpowered, I guess, even for that fact. But yeah, just leave me a comment. I want to know what you guys are thinking. Do you like the beta? Do you not like the beta? If you could change anything about it, what would you change? Just leave a comment below. Alright, well, I don't know if you guys have noticed, but it's a 4v2, and I just feel kind of bad for the other team, because they're pretty much just taking the damage that we're dealing out. They really don't have any defenses, because we're just, since it's a 4v2, we're pretty much just double teaming them, and we're coming from every angle, and it's just really, it's complete ownage. And I'm actually surprised as to how well that these guys did. And now I'd like to take a little time to talk about the graphics for this game. Overall, I think that they're great graphics. There's nothing like too horrible, but I think the only thing I've noticed is that when moving quickly, there's a little bit of like drag. So like what I'm trying to say is like, if you guys have the beta and like, and you use the sprint perk, and you sprint, it's like you see like your person's like arm where it was like a second ago, like it drags it. Like it's hard to explain, but if I ever like put up a video where I'm sprinting, I'll probably point it out just to show you guys what it looks like. But I think that's if they can just get it so that it doesn't lag or something, I don't really know what to call it, but if they can fix that, I think that the graphics would definitely be one of the best for a game that I've seen. Revenge. And alright guys, well, the video is coming to an end. It winds up that the time limit gets reached, so yeah. Just final score is 21-11, which is pretty good for me actually, because I used to play Halo 3 all the time, but I was just never any good at it. I'm only like a level 20, 30 seconds and that's in just regular Team Slayer. So yeah, this is probably one of my better games, probably because the other team only had two people, but whatevs, no big deal. Yeah, alright guys, just like the video, comment as to the questions I asked you before, and subscribe to the channel. Alright guys, thanks a lot, see you later.
Game over.